account.
Barry, let's go. What are biased. What are we talking about?
What are we talking about?
So
I gotta lead every single one of them.
Here, no, I can lead it.
Welcome.
All right, so we got a special this week. We're gonna be talking about summer's over. big summer movies.
That was the fastest summer ever.
We're gonna be talking about our top five favorite summer movies, and we're also gonna talk about our top five most surprising movies.
Whoa! I just did most surprising. Okay, I can do it though.
That is.
You have a lot of lists for just one thing.
Next has cue cards. Yeah. All right, so you know, most surprising meaning we were really looking forward to it, thought it was gonna be awesome, and it was really disappointing, or the opposite. Weren't really, you know, it was under our radar, and we saw it, and it was blew our minds.
Yep.
Planet of the Apes. Rise of Planet of the Apes was a big one last summer for everybody.
Perfect example.
Alright, so, Max, let's start with you. Favorite movies of the summer.
Favorite movies of the summer.
No, I won't do that to you. You can think about it for a little bit. Barry, why don't you start with your favorite movies of the summer?
Okay.
He's looking it up right now.
Whichever list you want to start with.
Favorites are fine. I'm going to go ahead and just do number one right away.
You want to go 1-1-1, 1-2-2-2?
I just want to go one because I think it might be across the board.
Okay.
I thought Avengers was my favorite summer movie. Just how much fun I had, it actually being a good summer movie. Like,
yeah.
Plot-wise, action-wise, it didn't disappoint me. I would say that's my number one.
Yeah, went and saw that 3 times in the theater. I don't go see movies very often more than once in the theater, so I didn't necessarily put mine in order, but yeah. The Avengers would be a pretty easy number one if I did.
Yeah.
And I would just jump right in and say, yeah, I totally agree, but man, for me, The Dark Knight Rises is pretty epic. That's the end of a time in our lives.
Yeah, I mean,
Dark Knight Rises and Avengers, I love them for different reasons.
Well, we can probably assume both those movies are on all of our lists.
Yeah.
Yeah, Dark Knight's on my list.
But I don't have a pick. I think it's interesting that you picked Avengers.
Number one?
Yeah. Avengers, number one!
I picked that one just because it's a perfect summer movie.
Yeah.
It's like,
it is very summer.
Batman's become a summer movie, but like, Batman didn't have the humor.
Batman's like a fall. Feels like a fall.
The Avengers have. That one didn't have the...
I had more fun watching bright. Avengers.
And that's another point, too. It's okay, more enjoyable.
Next.
So, obviously, Dark Knight was my other one.
Okay.
What else did I put on my list? Oh, Cabin in the Woods. That's not on this damn list. We counted it.
That would be my number one.
Yeah.
If it had come out in summer.
Ah, damn. No. That sucks. Well, I saw the Shut Up and Play the Hits. It was a documentary on the last show of LCD Sound System at Madison Square Garden, and they shot it during there. And that's in my top five. It was a one night only kind of showing, so it's kind of like they just.
So it was a documentary taking place over one day.
It was over the concert. He did a concert like a 4 hour set like at Madison Square Gardens, and they just said that's their last show ever. And these people documented it from a few days before, like maybe a week beforehand, and maybe a couple, like, I think maybe as long as 1 or 2 days after the show, if not just the direct day afterwards.
Mm-hmm.
And then there was an interview going on at the time, and they were cutting in, like, full-length songs and stuff. And the DVD release is going to have the full concert as well. So, yeah, it was awesome, though. And it was the best sounding movie I've ever heard at Liberty. Liberty did not disappoint me. So that was a big one.
Okay, what's your next one?
Again, mine aren't in any order, but
Ender.
I have Moonrise Kingdom.
Yeah, it's on my list too.
It's another one for me. Not necessarily a huge Wes Anderson fan, but love Moonrise Kingdom. I also have Magic Mike on here.
Yeah,
which was actually probably should be in my surprising movies as well. Not because I didn't think it was going to be good, I just didn't think I was going to love it as much as I did.
Can I see a list?
My last one, Ruby Sparks.
See, that's
was
one.
Amazing. Fell in love with the girl who played Ruby Sparks.
She's
fell
awesome.
In love with the entire movie. It was magical. It was
I'm jealous
just a joy. It was awesome.
I missed that one.
See, I feel like my list, like when I was going over it, the ones that I would, that were less, I feel like this is going to be my least amount blockbuster list, you know, throw in Avengers, throw in Dark Knight, for posterity even, if, you know, but I liked a lot of, like, little small movies over the summer. Like, and I wanted to see Beast of the Southern Wild was one that I knew was going to be on my list, but I missed it. Ruby Sparks is one that I knew was going to be on my list, but I missed it. Safety Not Guaranteed would be on my list, but I missed it.
Didn't like Beast of the Southern Wild too much. But yeah, I definitely wanted to see Safety Not
Chernobyl Guaranteed. Diaries, yeah. That was another one.
Did you see that?
No, it was the first one I saw on this list.
It was okay.
All right, well, the rest of my top ones are kind of the surprise, too. So what are some other best movies?
That's my whole list. The summer, honestly, I don't think it's as great of a summer as the last few summers we've had. I only had seven movies on my list that I needed to whittle down to five. You know, whenever I went through the list of summer movies, I wasn't adding a ton that I needed to then, you know, bring down to five. I only had seven.
See, I kind of felt the feeling of the summer was a lot of films that we didn't expect much going into, or we didn't think were going to be that great. We really enjoyed, like, I know you guys didn't enjoy it as much, but my surprise about Brave is that it wasn't as well received and that you guys didn't like it as much. Because I loved Brave. I can't wait for it to come out.
I love the first third to a half of that movie.
Okay, here's my theory on...
If they could have just continued something with that, I would have...
Here's my theory on Brave. Loved it. It goes back to the marketing. Like, it looks... The Brave trailers look like it's going to be this big, long, expansive, epic quest. But really, the story is very at home, very small.
Well, yeah. That's maybe an issue with trailers. They couldn't really give away a lot of what happened. A lot of what made the movie magical and beautiful, because that's a huge...
But I like that. I like that. I like that you came in and it was surprising.
I don't know. How to Train Your Dragon, though, it stayed pretty low-key. It did not make it a magical quest. They stayed in one area. But that movie was awesome. Like, I wanted Brave to have more of that kind of feeling. You know, like, less... I mean, I don't give a shit about a mother and daughter relationship right now. Like, less of that, more make her stronger. I don't know. Like,
okay,
it could have been cool.
You've made your point.
Yeah,
your wrong point. Also, I was really impressed by Paranorman. Again, we didn't expect much.
Impressed by that too.
And we already said this before, but the sound design in Paranorman, like, something I still think about. Just, I love the sound. I love that. It's really awesome. We didn't expect it. Another one we didn't expect.
Oh, so we're talking about surprising right now.
Yeah. My biggest surprise of the summer, and I'm sorry that it's negative because we're trying to enjoy every movie, my biggest surprise was that Spider-Man was lame. And I played Spider-Man down. I said it wasn't...
Yeah, that shouldn't be that big of a surprise for you.
No, listen, because I'm revealing the truth right now. I played it down. I love Tobey Maguire. I played it down, but really I was like, oh my god, this suit looks awesome. 3D, I can't wait. Just lame.
Yeah.
But Total Recall. Who would have known Total Recall would be the most action-packed movie ever? The most
action... Total Recall in the summer?
Yeah.
Just barely.
See that? I may have put that on my list.
The most action-packed movie.
Yeah.
That's ever been created ever. Came out this summer, so that's exciting. I love the director.
I'd say negative.
It's shocking.
Bourne let me down a little bit. I liked it, but it still let me down.
I was pleasantly surprised by Bourne.
But I think adjusting your views a little bit makes it a lot better.
Yeah.
But I still enjoyed it a lot, but it wasn't... It let me down because I feel like Bourne movies, everybody... Like, it's one of those things, like, everybody likes a Bourne movie. Like, there's no way that you don't. And then this one, people actually didn't like
it.
And that kind
of stuff. Well, but there was never only just one.
It's true. Good one, Max.
Why would there only be just
one? All right. We got any more surprises?
I watched one that was on the list called The Loved Ones. And it was just kind of like, I thought it was just going to be another cheesy horror movie. And that's probably one of the, like, it.
The Loved Ones?
The Loved Ones. It, and like, it was awesome. Like, gory, fucked up, creepy, like, well shot. It was pretty rad. I would recommend seeing it.
I just had to take a break from horror movies since Cabin in the Woods. I love horror movies. I just got to take a break because that just...
Yeah.
All right,
I watched it last night. It's hard for me to bring up the movie I just brought up after watching Cabin in the Woods 2.
I got Dark Shadows in my surprise list.
Surprise?
Yeah, surprise, because I did not think it was going to be that horrible.
Surprise, it's terrible.
I told you that.
I thought it was going to be bad. Watch the expectations. I thought it was going to be just as bad as everybody else, but man, it was way worse than that's horrible. True. I also have The Dictator, which turned out to be a lot funnier than I expected it to be.
I don't like it as much as you do.
You didn't see it, but you didn't like it?
I know. Oh,
you don't like Sacha Baron.
Not as much.
You don't have as many shirts with as many quotes as well.
Yeah. I don't have one from each movie.
Men in Black is on my list.
That was surprisingly good,
because
too.
Because it was awesome.
Yeah.
And I don't really like the Men in Black series or franchise.
It makes the whole franchise better.
Yeah.
It does. Makes the other two movies more.
That's My Boy. It's on my list.
Surprisingly good.
Had a lot of fun with that movie. And it's an Adam Sandler movie. It's supposed to be horrible. It probably was horrible, but I had a lot of fun with it.
Yeah.
And Prometheus is also on my list, which I kind of mentioned in the last episode. Thought it was going to be amazing sci-fi, you know, just fall in love with the movie.
I'd agree with that.
And I actually still enjoyed it a lot. It was actually one of the seven in my
top. It's visually just gorgeous.
Yeah, I mean, I loved it still, but it was just not just what I wanted it to be.
Open
a
bottle of wine, put it on mute. Just watch it. Just watch it slow. Turn off all the lights.
Slow, you're in the slow-mo now?
I'm in the slow-mo now. The drug.
Do we got any more?
I think the theme of the summer for me, what was the theme of the summer for you guys? The theme of the summer was me, it was like, I had a blast, there was a bunch of great films, I had so much fun at the theaters this summer, and then in between, the ones that we didn't think were going to be as big or as good, to me, they were all surprisingly better than I thought. So I had a great summer with you guys.
I'd honestly say,
we did it.
For me, I would say the same thing, every movie that they touted as going to be great was a disappointment, except Avengers.